did Tom Pershing. These are my roommates.
I'm Caroline Potts.
I'm Kenneth Acquah.
And we perform the coffee industrial engineering analysis. So before we begin, I'm just going to give everyone a brief overview as to what we'll be covering today. First, we're going to give you some background information as to the two firms that we studied, as well as any mathematical theory we use in our analysis. Then we'll move on to how we collect our data, as well as how we analyze our data. Then we'll move on to how we create our simulation, as well as any comparisons between the results from our simulation and the observed data that we collected. Finally, we'll move on to our findings, as well as our conclusions. We're talking a little bit about some future applications of the simulations that we created.
So the main piece of our project is to compare services and Dunkin Donuts. So I'll start off with a bit of background about Starbucks. Starbucks was founded in 1971 by Jerry Baldwin and Zeb Siegel in Golden Plastic. And changes were implemented by Howard Schultz, such as making more of an authentic coffee house. The business model for Starbucks prioritizes customer satisfaction, and it aims to be a third place away from home and work. Starbucks also has over 22,000 stores worldwide. For Dunkin Donuts, Dunkin Donuts was founded in 1950 by William Rosenberg, and changes were implemented by John Luther, such as shifting the focus from food items to drinks. The business model for Dunkin Donuts prioritizes quick service, and customers don't linger in the store, they move in and out, unlike Starbucks. Dunkin Donuts also has over 11,300 stores worldwide. This is a chart of Starbucks and Dunkin Donuts in comparison to Starbucks. So the store models show that Starbucks emphasizes customer satisfaction and Dunkin Donuts emphasizes quick service.
So as an industrial engineering analysis, our project lies at the intersection of business modeling and mathematical application. Now, we will be using a theoretical background as part of cube theory, which was applied to various industries in with the purpose of improving consumer output or firm efficiency and product output. And of that, we're going to use the resturant simulation software, which will apply those principles of cube theory. And it will model those processes as observed within those particular firms. And we will also use a mini-tab statistical package to model, to analyze the data that we have collected. And we will further impose that analyzed data into our simulations to further accurately represent those firm observations, and then we can make a usable simulation from there.
So to collect the data for our research project, over a span of 5 days, we visited a Dunkin' Donuts and a Starbucks location in New Brunswick. And we used a timer application to record the time from when the customer first got in line to when they ordered their drink, and from when they first got in line to when they received their order. And a couple of difficulties we had with this methodology were, first of all, human error, just starting and stopping the timer exactly when the process has occurred. And secondly, that on the first day of data collection, we all had slightly different methods. For example, some of us were starting the timer when the customer first walked in the door, and some of us were when the customer first got online. And little differences like that could affect our data. This is a picture of the timer application that we used to record. This is the Starbucks store layout. This is how we observe the store to look when we visited. You can see in blue that there were generally two cashiers, and in yellow, typically two baristas. And the red circles are where we sat to observe the line. This is the Starbucks process map, which is the processes that we saw customers go through to receive their drinks. Basically, first the customer would walk in the store and get online, then they would go up to a cashier and order their drink. And if they ordered a hot drip coffee, which is a pre-made stock hot coffee, then the cashier themselves would make the drink and give it to the customer. But if it was any other type of specialty drink, the cup was passed on to a barista who would make the drink and give it to the customer. This is the Dunkin' Donuts store layout. You can see it's slightly different from that of Starbucks. The first difference is that you can see in yellow there was only one barista at Dunkin' Donuts as opposed to two at Starbucks. And secondly, you can see that the line to the cashier is more direct at Dunkin' Donuts. This is the Dunkin' Donuts process map, which is also slightly different from the Starbucks process map. The main difference is that when a customer orders either a hot or an ice drip item at Dunkin' Donuts, it's made by the cashier, whereas at Starbucks, only hot drip items are made by the cashier. And at both stores, any other items are made by the barista.
All right, so after 5 days of data collection, we get a match of roughly 500 data points. In order to sort and analyze all these data points, we use a software called MiniTab, which is very similar to Excel. At first, we section all the data points by restaurant as well as by drink type. We then ran a set of basic descriptive statistics, including mean, median, maximum, and minimum. After all that was done, we ran a series of hypothesis tests for each section of data, in which we determined the best probability distribution for each section. To do this, MiniTab output to us a series of graphs as well as two values, p-values and Anderson-Darling values. P-values ranging 0 to 1 should be as high as possible. However, any p-value that exceeds an arbitrary alpha value, which is usually set around 0.05, deems that the probability distribution is an acceptable fit for the data. The Anderson-Darling value can exceed 1, however, it should be as low as possible. And the Anderson-Darling values are generally used just to reaffirm any conclusion we have drawn from the p-values. As you can see here, this was what was output to us. On the left-hand side, you can see that the data points will graph onto the probability distributions. And on the right-hand side, you can see we have a table with p-values as well as Anderson-Darling values. The mean tab would output to us 4 of these tabs for a total of 16 possible probability distributions. And using a combination of the visual graphs as well as the p-values and the Anderson-Darling values, we were able to determine the best probability distribution for any section of data. Once that was determined, we created a histogram of the data and overlaid the best probability distribution onto that histogram.
So once we had collected and analyzed all the data, it was time to move on to inputting the data into the remote simulation. Simulations can translate observations made in the real world into a model. They can be used to optimize customer outflow, and specifically for the restaurants of Dunkin Donuts and Starbucks, they can be used to increase profitability and efficiency. So simulations is a good way to evaluate and manipulate situations in business without disturbing normal day-to-day activity. Simulations use data to make themselves more accurate to the actual scenario. This is the Starbucks simulation that we made in the Arena soft simulation software. Simulations work with 3 main components. There's the entity, which moves through the simulation. There is a process, which acts upon the entity, and the resources, which is what the entity uses to act upon, which is what the process uses to act upon the entity. Entities line up in queues in order to wait to use resources, and resources can be changed and manipulated to experiment with better customer outflow and efficiency. As you can see, the entity, which going from the left side is the customer, goes into the simulation and is acted upon by the process, which is taking an order. The resources are the baristas and cashiers and the register.
So this is our Dunkin Donuts simulation. As in that, we can see that the customers enter the simulation on the far left, following in a right times pattern of a distribution called the Poisson process. And as they move on, they make their drink order. Their drink order gets separated into 4 different processes, depending on which drink order they make. And furthermore, their payment process is different in Dunkin Donuts, depending on which drink order they make. In fact, the customers may pay before or after the drink is made in the case of Dunkin Donuts. And then we actually model those production processes of those individual drinks using collected data that we analyze using many tabs. And with that gives us an accurate representation of our simulation and of the firm operations such that the simulation is quite effective.
This is the simulation analysis data for overall surgeon time. Overall surgeon time is the time from when a customer enters the line to when they receive their drink at the end of the process. We use the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test to test the accuracy of our simulation. And the Kolmogorov-Smirnov test is a test that compares the cumulative distributions of the 2 data sets, observed and simulated, and assigns a specific KS value to show similarity. The Kolmogorov-Smirnov test also assigns a specific critical value, and if the KS value is below the critical value, we can determine that the distributions match. For the Starbucks latte and overall solution time, our conclusion was that distributions match. On the left side, we see the Dunkin' Donuts latte, which for overall solution time here as well, similar to distribution. This is the simulation analysis results for service time. Service time is the time from when a drink is ordered to when the drink is in the customer's hand. This is the service time for the order to Frappuccino at the Starbucks restaurant, and the KS value is below the critical value, showing the distributions match. If you look to the left side, you can see the histogram of the Starbucks Frappuccino, the data that we collected, and the simulation data. As you can see, the data are very similar, showing that we produce an accurate simulation. This is the simulation analysis result for service time. While the KS value is above the critical value, meaning the distributions do not match, the 2 data sets are shown to be similar by the histogram. The reason the distributions do not match exactly is because of lack of time and
and a small amount of data points, relatively small sample size.
Alright, so ultimately our research found that Dunkin Donuts overall had more social times than that of Starbucks in this reason, and this conclusion can be related upon several reasons. From our observations, we know that several cashiers participate in the type of process called the process overlay debt, and that occurs when a cashier is doing two tasks at once, such as servicing a customer as well as making a drink. And so that actually interferes with our simulation because it is rather difficult to explicitly model those complex employee behavior models. And so we cannot, it's quite difficult for that to impose within our simulation that we made here. Furthermore, we know that Dunkin' Donuts actually just takes less time to make those drinks. Their production machines are expedited toward a quicker model of product. And furthermore, Dunkin' Donuts has a shorter customer interaction as opposed to Starbucks, which offers a lot more customer loyalty and brand value. And so with that conclusion, we know that these particular firms and their operations actually model their business models in a reflective manner, because Dunkin' Donuts, of course, is much faster than the value of Starbucks in a sense. So now we know that the simulations are accurate models. We know that we can take these observations and accurately impose them within a virtual platform that is perfectly viewable and interchangeable in order to create better conclusions. So that leads to our future applications. Once we know that the simulations are accurate representations, we can change them, we can change different properties of them, such as resource management or workflow rotation, such that these simulations can yield new results, which essentially transposes into the real world to show how these firms operate within changing conditions.
We'd like to acknowledge our mentor, Brandon Beats and Julie Malavade, for their undying help and support. We'd also like to thank the director of the Governor School of Engineering Technology, Dr. Eileen Rosen, and the associate director, Jean-Patrick Antoine. We'd like to thank the New Brunswick Starbucks and Dunkin' Donuts establishments for letting us conduct our research in their facility. And we'd like to thank the following sponsors of the Governor School of Engineering and Technology. These are the resources for the copious research that we did for our project.